Hey everybody, it's Mr. Marks here. Welcome to Tuesday, March 24th, I believe. I'm losing track of the days, you guys. Anyway, hey, I wanted you to welcome to our channel for today. Lots to go over. First of all, I want to give credit to the Rolling Stones for their opening intro. You can't always get what you want, but if you try sometimes, you might just find you get what you need. Some nice words of advice from Mick and Keith and the boys. Anyway, teach rock. Anyway, I want to talk about a couple things today. Biggest thing I want to mention is the student learning activities packet has been released. We'll talk a little bit about that in a few moments. First things first, about staying home and staying healthy. Our governor went ahead and announced that it's important to stay home and stay healthy. So that means you guys need to be really staying at home and not going out. I know it's hard, it's tough, you get really cabin fever and you're stuck inside all the time, but it's one of those things we have to do as Washingtonians. We have to avoid doing things like this. This is Alki Beach a few days ago, which is kind of in my neighborhood, and this is really kind of scary when people are getting together like this when there's a pandemic going on. So please, you guys, stay at home, stay away from big openings. I know you have Sewer Park and things like that near you, but do your best to avoid those areas. Doesn't mean you can't go outside though. You can still stay inside and or see outside and enjoy the weather if it's nice. It was a little rainy today. Walk along the beach. You can also go up to walk along Beacon Avenue. There's lots of places you can go around and enjoy the weather. Just to keep your social distancing to 6 feet and avoid these kinds of things. And also remember to wash your hands. Little shout out here to everyone in our class. We've now answered 10,000 IXL questions on IXL, so that's pretty good. I can see that some students are out there doing that. I'd like to shout out to IA, EC, IH, and KW for working on IXL the last 7 days. You helped us get to 10,000 problems. Thank you. Let's go for 20,000. All right, the biggest thing now that came out yesterday is the suggested learning activities packet. It looks like this. This is the one for second and third grade. You can either download it here, you can download it on the website, you can go and get it at school. Rising Star will be open from 11 to 1 p.m. every day, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. And any of the other food sites that the district is putting out there. So you can get it any place. Go, but school is probably the easiest one to get to. Anyway, so these are some suggested learning activities for second and third grade students. Now, Seattle schools are committed to making online information accessible and usable to all people, regardless of ability or technology. So I know a lot of us are out there don't have access to a computer. So here's one way that you can get access to our learning activities. And if you have any difficulty accessing this material or have any questions, please contact your student's teacher. That's me. And my contact information is at the end of this message. So let's take a look at this packet here. One thing, the second page here talks about the broadcast schedule of the SPS TV channel 26. I believe our own Mr. Watan and Miss Brandt are some of the actors and actresses who are teaching some of these lessons. So tune into that. I might include some links at the end. Let's see here. One of the easiest things you guys can do is a reading log. Keep track of what you're reading. What's the author? What's the genre? How do you like it? And also, you can have some writing ideas it gives you in this packet as well. You can choose a writing prompt that you can free write on. Write about something special you've done with someone you love. Make up a story about an interesting person you know. Write a letter to someone. Hey guys, write me a letter. I love to hear from you. Send me an email. I'll write you back. That'd be a great way for you to do your writing skills. There are a nice lots of math problems in here. There's second grade and third grade. I know this one's a fun, simple math game you can play with your child at home during this week. It says second grade families, but hey, third grade students can totally do this as well. So play these games. There's a special section on third grade math on page 24. Gives you a little letter here about, we know it's a, you are, we hope you're all well during this difficult time, and we hope this series of letters will help you pass the time, let you get your students, get let you get to know your students as mathematicians. Yes, that's what I call our students all the time, mathematicians. So this would be a good way for you to guys keep track of what we're doing. There shouldn't be anything new in here. It should be mostly review of what we've done already. I know it starts off with some review for like place value. We did that already, you know, value of digits like 2000s, 800s, 310s, 51s, some adding and subtracting. Lots of good stuff to keep you busy. Let's see here. I wanted to also show you that there is even stuff, important stuff like the arts. You have the message here from the arts, visual and performing arts team in Seattle Public Schools that put together art activities that you can do while the schools are closed. I know my son, he's getting involved in his little art activities, and he's making cool videos using Lego figures, and I've been helping with that and having a lot of fun with that as well. So things like that, you can make you know, arts free. You know, it doesn't cost anything. You know, get some sidewalk chalk and draw. You know, I've seen a lot of sidewalk chalk art out there. But yeah, it would really help. And also, when you're cooped in inside all day, art and drawing is a wonderful way to pass the time. Also, another way to pass the time is keeping up with your physical fitness. So. On page 36, there's some physical education. The physical education team in Seattle Public Schools are working with resources to help you stay healthy and fit and active while the schools are closed. Mr. Watan, our kindergarten teacher, put down the challenge to me that I can do 100 push-ups. Well, hey, I started today at about 20, 10 more, so I got 30 already done today. I want to try to get 70 and more. So he's doing 100 push-ups a day, and I'm figuring, you know, I can do that too. Keeping track of it on my handy dandy list right here. You know, did 20 today, 20 and 10. And I could do 10 more today when watching YouTube or something like that. I could knock out 10, no problem. Anyway, it's a good way for you to stay active and fit, and you can, it also gives you a log that you can keep track of all the work that you are doing. Let's see here. Let's go back to our PowerPoint here. So, other ways you can get a hold of me. Email is probably the best way. MG Marks, that's Michael Gordon Marks at seattleschools.org. And it's probably the quickest and most efficient and professional way to get a hold of me. Also, Class Dojo is another way you can get a hold of me and ask me questions. I'm thinking about starting a Twitter account. I don't know if I want to go down that road yet, but that might be a good way for me to be able to get information out to all of our families. So let me just kind of show you a little bit what you can do with Class Dojo. Let's say here, this is an example of what a parent will see. This is, oh no, you didn't just do that to me. So the problem with technology is when you're recording live, it doesn't necessarily work. I was kind of hoping to show you what it looks like if you were to send a message to me. And it looks like, you know, this is not the first time Class Dojo has crashed on me during an important lesson. Thanks a lot, Class Dojo. Well, never mind about that. Anyway, you can send a message to me. I'll try to repost it. Go on this class story. You can find out how to ask questions. I was going to model how to ask a question about the learning packet that we've just sent out. So I will go ahead and follow up with that. Let's see here. So that's about it for today. I'm hoping that more people start watching these broadcasts. Like to hear from you. I'm going to keep the comments open for today's broadcast because I would like to hear from you. So please write a comment down below, and like to hear how everyone's doing. Don't use your real names though, or maybe just initials would be great. Also, I'm intending to continue to read from Ramona Quimby, age 8. Tomorrow, I'll do a public service announcement about washing your hands. And then Thursday, I would like to go over any problems that you have in that work packet. So, you know, go ahead, download the work packet. Go to school, pick one up. Start working on it. If there's anything you're have trouble with, send me a message, and I like to model that on Thursday's broadcast. So I hope you're all doing all right. Hope you're staying safe. Hope you're enjoying spending time with your families and not driving each other too crazy yet. I know it's tough. We had a pretty packed house here the other day, and it's hard to do that when you're keeping social distances. But especially when you're just with the same people all the time, it gets to be a little rough. So I totally understand. Anyway, I'd like to thank everyone for visiting today. And just remind you that you can email me right here at mgmarks@seattleschools.org. You can message me on Class Dojo. And coming soon, Remind is a way that you can text message me. And Twitter, we'll see. All right, please like, subscribe to this channel. Hope to see you soon. All right, back to the Rolling Stones to finish this off. All right. Have a good afternoon, everybody. Bye-bye.